They're neighbors in the Horn of Africa that have come together to fight a common threat. But historic relations between the two countries have been anything but smooth. Here's an in-depth look at the contentious ties between Ethiopia and Eritrea. The Eritrean-Ethiopian War lasted for 2 years from 1998 to 2000 and was sparked by a dispute over the border town of Badme located in Tigray state. But hostilities continued for two decades, claiming nearly 80,000 lives, and the conflict wasn't formally resolved until 2018 when the two countries signed a peace agreement. Eritrea seceded from Ethiopia in 1993 after a long battle for independence. The Ethiopian Civil War started in 1974 when the Marxist Derg established a military junta after staging a coup against then-Emperor Haile Selassie. But the junta was weakened after the fall of communism in Eastern Europe. So a coalition of rebel groups led by the Tigrayan People's Liberation Front, known as TPLF, overthrew the government in the capital Addis Ababa and installed its own transitional government. Tigray is one of the major ethnic groups of Ethiopia and is at the center of the current ongoing conflict. The group was dominant in the nation's politics for about three decades before falling out with the Ethiopian government. Later, an international commission at The Hague ruled that Eritrea had broken international law by invading Ethiopia. Ethiopia reclaimed all of its invaded lands and also made gains into Eritrea. But a UN body, the Eritrea-Ethiopia Boundary Commission, stated that the disputed Badme territory in fact belonged to Eritrea. In 1991, the UN stated that the transitional government in Eritrea should hold a referendum to establish if Eritreans wanted to secede, leading to Eritrea's independence 2 years later. A commission from both countries was unable to resolve problems between them, and relations rapidly deteriorated. Eritrea, becoming an independent nation, transformed disputes over Badme from an internal problem to one along a newly created international border. After multiple armed conflicts in 1998, Ethiopia led a full assault on Eritrea. Eritrea rejected a US-Rwanda peace plan, and Ethiopia launched an offensive to recapture Badme in 1999. The warring soon became a regional problem when the two countries formed alliances with forces in Somalia and Sudan. A turning point in the war came when Ethiopia scored a major victory by capturing the strategic town of Barentu, which gave it full control of the western battlefront. Barentu was a command center and major supply route for Eritrea on the western front with Badme. But the Tigrayans had suffered the brunt of the war, and the TPLF refused to cede Badme. The Algiers Agreement finally led to a cessation of hostilities in 2000 when the parties finally agreed to a peace deal. A UN Security Council resolution created the Temporary Security Zone, supported by 60 countries. Though the war had come to an end, tensions still continued between the two neighbors for the next two decades, after a court at The Hague awarded Badme to Eritrea. And once The Hague ruled in 2005 that Eritrea had violated international law by attacking Ethiopia in 1998, the two nations remobilized their troops along the border. Both sides were accused of supporting rebels, but the countries did not return to all-out war. Tensions continued, however, pulling in regional and international players. After the UN accused Eritrea of backing Al-Shabaab fighters in Somalia, the UK, along with the US and its allies, placed an arms embargo and travel ban on Eritrea in 2009 and froze its assets. Eritrea denied the claims, and after being cut off from the larger international community, developed ties with other nations, including Iran, Venezuela, and North Korea. As the US's most important ally in the region, Ethiopia used its position to pressure the UN into isolating Eritrea. Relations between Ethiopia and Eritrea were not restored until 2018, which also saw the lifting of sanctions against Asmara. The 2018 peace process was kick-started by the coming to power of Ethiopia's new Prime Minister Abiy Ahmed. Ethiopia accepted the Algiers Agreement in its entirety, including the return of Badme to Eritrea. Eritrean Foreign Minister Osman Saleh led a delegation to Addis Ababa in June. In the following month, Eritrea's President Isaias Afwerki and Ethiopia's Prime Minister Abiy Ahmed signed a formal joint declaration in Asmara, ending the state of war between their nations. The countries reopened embassies, border crossings, and trade routes, and Ethiopian Airlines resumed operations to Eritrea. The thawing of relations opened the potential for landlocked Ethiopia's access to Eritrean ports and more inclusion for isolated Eritrea. Two years after the historic agreement, however, diplomatic progress stalled between the two countries. Ethiopian soldiers still remained in Badme, and the port of Assab in Eritrea is still closed to Ethiopia, which it had access to until 1997. And there have been objections to what's been seen as Abiy Ahmed's growing authoritarian rule, complete with internet blackouts, media bans, and imprisonment of politicians. The Eritrean government has also been accused of jailing opponents and forcing citizens into military or government service for long periods of time. The two countries seem to only have found common ground over their shared hostility toward the TPLF. In November, an armed conflict broke out in Ethiopia's Tigray region. Ethiopian and Eritrean forces joined together to fight a common threat from the TPLF. The situation escalated after the Ethiopian government declared the Tigray regional elections as illegal, which the TPLF's now ousted leader, Debretsion Gebremichael, held in defiance of the federal government. The once powerful faction in the former Ethiopian ruling coalition fell from grace as Tigrayan leaders resisted Prime Minister Abiy Ahmed's efforts to centralize power in the federal government. After coming to power, Prime Minister Abiy Ahmed had arrested and expelled Tigrayan leaders from key government positions. The U.S. pointed to reports it cited as credible, saying that Eritrean forces had joined the fight, and UN teams in Tigray also said they had seen Eritrean troops there, but both Ethiopia and Eritrea have publicly denied the claims. Refugees from the area started to flee to neighboring Sudan and made similar claims of seeing Eritrean troops. Prime Minister Abiy Ahmed announced the end of the military offensive at the end of November, after government forces captured the Tigrayan capital Mekele. But the TPLF countered the announcement by saying that the fighting was not over and that it was continuing to make gains. The US has since made calls for any such troops from Eritrea to leave Ethiopian territory, and a Senate resolution called for dialogue with Tigrayan leaders to avoid a larger regional conflict. Potential Eritrean involvement would further complicate Ahmed's efforts to pacify Mekele and the people in Tigray. Protesters in Tigray have defied orders by the new transitional leader to return to work. Ethnic Tigrayans claim that government officials have subjected them to discrimination, harassment, and abuse. Sudan's Prime Minister Abdullah Hamdok visited Addis Ababa for an emergency meeting of East African countries to resolve the crisis. The bloc includes Ethiopia, Sudan, Djibouti, Kenya, Somalia, South Sudan, and Uganda. The UN has expressed alarm over reports that Eritrean refugees in Tigray are being killed, abducted, and forcibly returned to Eritrea. Prime Minister Abiy Ahmed visited Mekele on December 13th for the first time since the offensive, and tweeted that he'd met with the Provisional Administration of Tigray, promising humanitarian relief and the restoration of electricity and communication lines. So, can the contentions over Tigray be resolved and regional stability restored?